Hello guys, welcome back to another video. Yesterday, Epic Games just revealed everything new coming to Unreal Engine 5.4 at GDC during the State of Unreal. They also released the preview version of Unreal Engine 5.4, as well as the public roadmap. And so in this video, we will be covering everything new coming to Unreal Engine 5.4. There's tons of new features coming in 5.4, things like Nanite runtime tessellation, which allows for fully dynamic and realistic detailed environments, which was not possible before. We have things like support for motion warping, which is a new game character animation system, and it includes a free template with over 500 free AAA motion capture animations. We have a brand new simplified retargeting system that has native support for most industry standard skeleton types, including Mixamo, Motion Builder, Extents, Move AI, and much more. We have things like a new modular control rig builder that allows you to quickly create a control rig for your character with just a couple of clicks, as well as some new rendering performance updates that allow for 30% faster shader compilation time. There are loads of PCG updates, including new nodes and a new PCG biome core plugin that allow for different biomes in an open world map. There are many more updates to things like motion graphics, including a complete motion graphics mode and viewport inside of Unreal Engine, and so much more. Now, a quick side note, if you guys are interested in creating games inside of Unreal Engine 5, I'm actually working on a remaster of my survival game course inside of Unreal Engine 5.4. I'm going to be remastering the entire course and adding new things like controller support, things like first person and third person mode, and also a lot of new features like common UI and enhanced input. And the game will even have support for playing in single player or multiplayer, whether that be a listen or dedicated server. So basically, this remaster will be free if you already have purchased my survival game course. So if you haven't picked up the course yet, I highly recommend you do, as I will be releasing the 5.4 remaster sometime after the official release of Unreal Engine 5.4. Now with all that out of the way, let's get right into the video. So the first of many big announcements coming to Unreal Engine 5.4 are the new additions to the animation side of the engine. First, we have motion matching, which is production ready in Unreal Engine 5.4. Motion matching is a powerful way to animate characters in games instead of using things like handcrafted state machines, which are what most games currently use. Motion matching uses a database of animations and selects the best animation to play based on the current pose of the character, and uses things like pose warp algorithms to fill in the gaps. You can use it for very smooth locomotion like what you see here, and it scales very well with any type of data set that you feed into it. Motion warping can additionally be used for interaction with world objects. So as you see here, it can be used for things like climbing, jumping, falling, and it creates very smooth and believable movement that you wouldn't otherwise be able to achieve with just simple animation states. Along with the motion warping system coming in Unreal Engine 5.4, Epic is releasing a free sample project that includes over 500 plus AAA animations created from motion capture data in this motion warping template, and it'll also be compatible with the MetaHuman rig. So this is a completely free template that you can use for your games to get started using motion warping. Next up, there are many new updates coming to animation in Unreal Engine 5.4. We have new animation authoring tools, like these new movement gizmos, constraints, and much more. But more importantly, they are introducing a brand new modular control rig framework that will help you create a control rig for any type of character in engine. It looks as simple as dragging and dropping preseted control rigs and watching the magic happen. And from the GDC talk, it sounds like they are really pushing forward in engine animation as the forefront for creating animations. And they are really trying to make it so you don't have to use any external DCC program to animate. All you need basically is Unreal Engine. Another huge update coming to the animation side of Unreal Engine 5.4, which wasn't really announced or revealed anywhere other than the roadmap, is a new animation retargeting system. Yes, retargeting is getting a complete rehaul in Unreal Engine 5.4, and it is absolutely incredible. With the new retargeting system in Unreal Engine 5.4, there is now native support for retargeting with the most common skeleton types. So this includes Mixamo, Motion Builder, Extents, Move AI, and much more. So all you have to do now is import the skeleton, all of the animations that you want to retarget, select your target animation. In my case, say I want the UE4 or UE5 mannequin, and click retarget. It's all built-in supported, so you don't have to mess around with creating things like the complex IK rigs or retargeters. It basically just works out of the box because they added that native support for most industry standard skeleton types. So this is just a huge quality of life update because now you can very quickly get animations retargeted for your custom character without having to spend half an hour or more creating the IK rigs and messing around with the IK retargeter system. Now, as for rendering, there are some huge updates coming to Unreal Engine 5.4 on the rendering side of the engine, including some big performance improvements. The first big new feature is nanite tessellation, which is a new experimental feature introduced in Unreal Engine 5.4, which allows nanite meshes to be modified at runtime using a displacement map or procedural material. They showcase this on their new Marvel game that uses this nanite displacement technology. And as you can see here, they use this displacement to layer on detail on the simple road. So they add things like brick, snow, and mud. And the nanite tessellation also has runtime support, so you can add things like tire tracks and even footprints on the ground during runtime. And as you can see here, the nanite view just shows you how extremely detailed and dense the geometry is to allow for ultra-realistic environments, which was not feasible before. Another feature of nanite tessellation that they showcase is adding things like snow to all the props in the world. So you can see that the nanite displacement allows for actual geometry on top of these meshes, which adds this realistic snow buildup to any of the actors in the world. Another new feature that was showcased was this realistic smoke volume. This is a heterogeneous volume, and this was a new experimental feature that was actually introduced in the engine back in 5.3, which allows for support of creating these volumes in external DCC programs and importing them into the engine. Now, a new feature in 5.4 is that these heterogeneous volumes, or the smoke itself, can cast its own shadow. So you can change the lighting in real time and see the smoke dynamically react to the lighting in the scene. Now, if you didn't already have a big reason to update to Unreal Engine 5.4, there are massive performance updates coming to the rendering system in 5.4, including faster lumen, shadows, and ray tracing. In Unreal Engine 5.4, they made major refactoring to the rendering systems in the engine, and they tested the city sample demo and compared the render thread, and the performance is roughly 2 times faster in 5.4 as compared to Unreal Engine 5.0. Another huge performance update to the rendering system in Unreal Engine 5.4 is the optimization of shader cook time. I think a lot of us are familiar with the compiling shaders. Well, in 5.4, there has been a significant overhaul in how shader compilation work is executed, with both increases to parallelization and a reduction in redundant work. So the results of this optimization effort are approximately a 30% fewer shaders being compiled, and all of these factors result in a significant improvement in project cook times. Among other rendering updates that were not showcased in GDC, 5.4 marks an experimental release of Vulkan ray tracing features in parity with DirectX 12 on the Linux platform. So this will allow for things like the full suite of ray tracing features to be used, including lumen and path tracing. World building and open worlds are also receiving their fair share of updates in Unreal Engine 5.4, including large world coordinates on the GPU. So large world coordinates in UE5 introduced support for double precision transforms and data types, allowing from the maximum world size to increase from 21 kilometers to over 88 million kilometers. Large world coordinate rendering support on the GPU was based on a tiled representation, which has its own number of limitations, including imprecision and jittering near tile boundaries. Large world coordinate rendering is undergoing a refactor to support full double precision representation on the GPU, which will allow for large worlds to be rendered more reliably when the camera is far away from the origin. Also, in terms of large worlds, we also have a new 5.4 experimental subworld partitions, which provides the possibility to have multiple subworld partitions within a level enabled through code or blueprint. We also have more updates to the nanite landscape system, including a nanite landscape automatic asynchronous build. So in previous versions, they announced nanite landscape support, where you could build a nanite mesh for your landscape. Now in 5.4, they added an async build support so that you can essentially sculpt your landscape, deform it, and in the background, it will automatically and asynchronously process the nanite tiles while keeping the editor responsive and provide up-to-date landscape nanite data on the fly. PCG, or the procedural content generation system, is also receiving tons of new updates in 5.4. There are loads of new nodes and operators that are being introduced into the PCG graph, but the most notable of PCG updates are the new experimental biome core plugin. So the new PCG Biome Core plugin is a data-driven biome generator built entirely using the PCG framework. It showcases the latest improvements and serves as an advanced example of world-building tool for productions. The Biome Core is a fixed pipeline using asset and biome definitions, well designed to be very flexible in dividing key components such as sampling, transforms, and filtering into separate problem spaces. Each of these can be completely customized to any project constraints or needs for using the PCG framework. Next up, for developer iteration, there have been a couple of new updates introduced in Unreal Engine 5.4, things like a Unreal Engine Cloud DCC solution. I explained these in a previous video, but basically it seems like these are a cloud-based solution for sharing things like cooked data between team members. This also includes things like authentication, enterprise login, and much more features, but this is more or less like a cloud solution for large teams or companies. So if you are interested in these particular features, I won't explain them all in this video, so I recommend you check them all out by reading them on the public roadmap. I'll link it in the description below. Next up, we are receiving lots of new updates for motion graphics in Unreal Engine 5. So if you're using Unreal Engine 5 for creating things like motion graphics, Unreal Engine 5.4 has a huge update for motion graphics, including a brand new motion graphics mode. So this new motion graphics mode is equipped with specialized tools for motion graphics designers and includes things like a 2D canvas with enhanced world outliner featuring intuitive hierarchies. The motion graphics mode provides a comprehensive suite, including 3D shapes, cloners, effectors, modifiers, animators, and features for non-linear animations. This dedicated mode is engineered to elevate the motion graphics design experience, offering a robust and user-friendly platform for designers to bring their creative visions to life. There are a lot more other motion graphics updates coming in 5.4. Some other noteworthy features are things like a SVG importer. And if you are into the motion graphics side, I highly recommend you check out all of the lists of updates on the public roadmap, link in the description below. Next up, we have audio. Audio is receiving its fair share of updates in Unreal Engine 5.4. Meta Sounds, which was introduced in 5.0, is now considered production ready in 5.4. Although Meta Sounds are still under heavy development with many new features and improvements planned, they have been shipped on all titles from Epic Games, many of which were built from the beginning on Meta Sounds, and they have made a number of performance and memory improvements to achieve this and plan on doing many more. Now, as for platform updates, now there are a few notable platform updates coming in Unreal Engine 5.4, including a experimental Apple Vision Pro support. So they expect to ship experimental support for the Apple Vision Pro's full immersion style in 5.4. And with this initial implementation, Unreal Engine supports stereo rendering through metal and camera transform given by the head-mounted display pose. Another experimental platform update is the support for Lumen on mobile. So this is a pretty interesting platform update because we are now seeing the support for some of these new Unreal Engine features that were previously limited to PC only, but are now receiving support for other platforms like mobile. Unreal Engine 5.4 also ships with loads of new modeling tools, UV tools, and now even texturing tools. So in 5.4, there are new experimental texturing tools. Essentially, it's like a texture graph editor that uses a node-based system. There's not a whole lot of information on this on the roadmap, but it appears to be some sort of way that you can create textures for your models in engine using some base color material nodes and different adjustment layers, filters, and blending. So I really think Unreal Engine is just coming full circle at this point because they've introduced things like modeling tools where you can model in engine. They have added UV unwrapping tools so you can unwrap the model, and now they're introducing these new experimental texturing tools so you can have the ability to texture that model in engine. So this will just be an interesting feature to keep your eye on and see where it goes in the next couple of updates. In terms of Unreal Engine framework, there are a few notable engine updates in 5.4, including large world coordinates network support. So this one stood out to me in particular. I'm interested in working on large open worlds, and the large world coordinates is now officially supported by Unreal Engine's network technology, which allows you to create large worlds in a multiplayer environment without having to worry about hitting networking related limitations. Another notable notable update is the nav mesh generation for large worlds. So while they were shipping LEGO Fortnite, they had to optimize many different systems inside of their navigation tools to have better support for larger and dynamic worlds. So one of these systems is the nav mesh generation, and they optimized it to have it come less of a bottleneck with large open worlds with huge amounts of AI present. Simulation and VFX are also receiving a few updates in 5.4. The Chaos Cloth panel editor, which was introduced in 5.3, is also receiving various different updates. It was also even featured at GDC, showcasing that you can use it inside of UEFN, and they even showed a pipeline from Marvelous Designer to the Chaos Cloth panel editor in Unreal Engine 5.4. Another notable update in the simulation and VFX side is the network physics support. So basically, they're adding support for network physics, which they've also used in Fortnite. They're adding two new capabilities, a predictive interpolation to provide responsive and accurate physics replication results, and a physics resimulation for if you need a pawn to be physics-based in a multiplayer game. There are a lot more updates to Chaos Physics, and among other things, the Unreal Editor is also receiving a few in-editor updates, and one of them is the ability to adjust the overall scale of the UI, which allows for better accessibility and scaling of just the general editor user interface. Now, there aren't a whole ton of rendering and virtual production updates in 5.4, but those that are the most notable are the new experimental virtual scouting toolset. So this new virtual scouting tools enable linear content creators to view, annotate, and edit your scenes in VR. So you can view and edit levels in VR. It also has a multi-user editor session where you can measure, annotate, and even play back things like level sequences. They've also added Live Link VCam for Android, the companion app to the in-editor virtual camera system, and also virtual camera is coming to Mac with full support in 5.4. There are other few updates to things like depth of field, and again, this is more for the virtual production side of the engine, so I'm not going to go too in detail about all these new updates. I recommend you check out the full list of features on the public roadmap, and there are a lot of more updates and features in Unreal Engine 5.4 that couldn't completely fit in this video. So if you guys want to see the full list of updates and features, you can check out the public roadmap. I'll leave a link to it in the description below. And it seems like we didn't get much updates to the virtual production or the film side of the engine, but it seems like it's more towards the game rendering and animation side. We have things like the new animation retargeter, which allows you to quickly retarget animations. We have the new experimental modular control rig that allows you to quickly create a control rig for any character using presetted options. We also have a new nanite tessellation, which allows for runtime nanite displacement. They've added a new motion warping template and animations for games, and there are loads of new motion graphics tools and updates, including its own dedicated motion graphics editing mode. There are also lots of updates to PCG and open world features. So yeah, let me know what features you guys are most excited about in Unreal Engine 5.4. I think it's just interesting to see that there's lots of quality of life updates coming in this new engine version. Things like the new animation retargeter. That one just seems like a no-brainer to me. But yeah, let me know what you guys think down in the comments down below. And also check out my multiplayer survival game course. Like I mentioned before, I'll be remastering it in Unreal Engine 5.4, so stay tuned for that. And as always, I'll see you guys in the next one.